Hello and welcome to the new session. We will be discussing about the introduction about the reverse course and two important problems on the reverse course. I'm quite sure you might have seen such signboards here while you're traveling on the highways, like this is the right reverse bend, this is the left reverse bend, and almost if you could look at the sign here, it is in the shape of yes. So I told you reverse curves, they are also called as yes curves or the serpentine curves. Okay. So these are the signboards indicating there is a reverse curve in the highway. Similarly, like you might have seen the curves in the shape of yes, even in most cases in the railways. Okay. So this is another typical example of a reverse curve where it will be provided in the railways. Okay. Now this is one line, the end of the bogie. There where you have rails, this is one line, and the starting of this engine here is the train, this is another straight line. So now what has happened here is we have two straight lines which are parallel, or the angle between them is very small. Okay, in that case we cannot provide a simple circular curve, neither we cannot provide a compound curve, whereas we have to go with the reverse curve. So please remember, when the angle between the two straights is very small, or if they are parallel, then we may have to provide a reverse curve. This is another example of a reverse curve provided on the highway. So if there is a over bridge here, over on the rail, okay. Now this is one straight, this is another straight, where we have to join these two straights by a curve, and we have no other choice than the reverse curve here. Similarly, this is another important aspect where we generally provide a reverse curve. So this way in the sketch A, skew alignment, skew crossing, this is a river, and if I construct a bridge across a river here, if you could look at this, the length of bridge is going to be larger here. Length is going to be larger when it is compared to in this fashion. Here your bridge is making 90 degree, almost 90 degree to the river, but here it is not so. Okay, so what happens is when by constructing the bridge, see, bridge construction of a bridge work is a tremendous work. It consumes all machineries, manpower, and the money. Okay, as far as possible, we should always reduce the length of the bridge. So in that case, we don't have any other choice than going with square crossing of the bridge across the river. The square crossing is when bridge is almost perpendicular to the river. In that case, then we may have to join the two alignments with a reverse curve. If you could look at this, this is again a reverse curve here, which is being used to join the straights. Okay. Now going to definition of a reverse curve, it is a curve which consists of two simple circular curves, but they are being joined. The two simple circular curves are in opposite direction, and the point where they meet, that junction point is called as point of reverse curvature. It is a common point, and that point is called as point of reverse curvature, PRC. So two simple circular curves join where the two simple circular curves are in opposite direction, that is centers are in opposite direction, that is called as a reverse curve. Okay. So this is generally being used when the two straight lines are parallel, as I showed you in the rails there. Okay, or else if the angle is too small, then we can go with the reverse curve. So generally they are being used in the highways, along mountains, okay, cities, in city limits, and in railways and in crossroads. These are the situations where we can use reverse curves. But reverse curves have their own disadvantages, so we should always avoid them whenever the speed is very high, both along highways and along the railways. Okay, so there's a sudden change. See, reverse curves are being joined by the two curves which are in opposite direction, and you all know that we have to provide super elevation at the outer edge. Now what happens is when at a point of juncture, the outer edge suddenly changes, so it becomes difficult to provide super elevation along the reverse curve, so we may have to restrict the speed there. Again, there's a sudden change of curvature in the at PR point of reverse curvature, so direction changes here, and this leads to a reduction of life of the vehicle. Okay, and it is also discomfort to the passengers on highways. it becomes very difficult to steer the vehicles along the rivers. Okay, and it is not possible to provide proper and super elevation at the point of reverse curvature. So these are few difficulties where we may have to avoid reverse curve. In that case, what we will be doing is we certainly have to restrict the speed of the vehicle while they are moving along the reverse curve. Okay, so that's why signboards are being always provided. Next, going to the elements of the reverse curve. I am basically talking the reverse curve where they are parallel. Okay, for your syllabus, you are supposed to deal with those reverse curves where they are being joined when the two straight lines or the two tangents, what we held, they are parallel. So whatever the red line it is being shown here, those are the two straight lines which are parallel to each other and they are away by V meter distance. The two straights are apart by V meter. Okay, this is of center of the first curve. So A is the starting point of the first curve. From A to E, we have a first curve with center O1 and with a deflection angle delta 1. Okay, deflection angle, it's always equals to angle at the center. So I'm just representing delta 1 at the center of the circle here. So the point E is point of reverse curvature, where from this, so it is being shared by both first and the second curve. Now this is a second curve. Point E is end of the first curve and at the same time it is the starting point of the second curve. So this is the second curve here. E to C, it is the second curve. Okay, with center O2 and deflection angle delta 2. Now, the red lines, they are going to be tangents to these curves. It means that we always know that radius is always perpendicular to tangent at that point. So line O1A is perpendicular to this tangent and line O2T2 is perpendicular to this tangent. Okay, so what has happened here is now O1A and O2C, O1A and O2C, they are actually parallel now. Okay, in such a type of reverse curves where the two tangents are parallel, these two lines are also parallel. It means your delta 1 is equals to delta 2. Angle at the centers, they are going to be equal. You can imagine them as the Z angles here. Okay, these two are parallel lines, you have an intersection line. So delta 1 and delta 2 are Z angles in the corner and they are going to be equal. Okay, now we will try to understand how to solve the different elements of the reverse curve. Again here, point A is a point of commencement, point E is point of reverse curvature and point T2 or point C is point of tangency. So generally what we will be knowing when we deal with a reverse curve is we will be knowing R1 and R2, that is radius of the curve, radii of the curve, different curves, and then delta 1 and delta 2, which are basically they happen to be equal. Okay, now let us try to understand some different elements here. Now AT1 and CT2 are the two straights which are parallel. Okay, so they are not meeting anywhere, there is no point of intersection here. Let R1 be the smaller radius and R2 be the larger radius. Delta 1 is being central angle corresponding to the first curve. Delta 2 is the central angle corresponding to the second curve. And we already know that delta 1 is equals to delta 2. Let L be the distance between the T1, T2. So the distance T1, T2 is capital L. Next, V is the perpendicular distance between the two straights. So this is the distance V. Okay, and similarly I have, there is a distance H, which is a distance between the perpendiculars at T1 and T2. So this is the distance H. Okay, and point E is point of reverse curvature. So we'll try to understand few, we'll try to derive few equations which are being involved in the reverse curve. For that we may have to construct some procedure. So at E, we are drawing a line which is parallel to the two tangents. At E, draw a line which are parallel to two tangents. Let this line intersect O1 T1 at B and O2 T2 at D. So BD is parallel to these two straight lines. BD is parallel to these two straight lines. So next, from the sketch, T1B can be written as O1 T1 minus O1B. Whereas O1 T1 is your radius. Okay, and O1B this happens to be r1 into cos delta 1. I am considering this triangle here. Okay, this becomes adjacent and hypotenuse becomes r1. Therefore, O1B becomes r1 into cos delta 1. So I am substituting this value. So T1B happens to be r1 into 1 minus cos delta 1. Just need not remember this versus sign. We'll go with only this expression. Okay. R1. So T1B is equals to r1 into 1 minus cos delta 1. Similarly, if I try to derive an expression for T2D, I'll be having T2D as r2 into 1 minus cos delta 1. Remember here, it is delta 2, but delta 1 is equals to delta 2. So I'm substituting delta 2 as delta 1. So T1D is equals to r2 into 1 minus cos delta 1. Next, if I want this distance V, is it not that from the sketch, your distance V is equals to T1B plus DT2. Okay. And I already have the expression for T1B and DT2. So if I could substitute it, your V happens to be R1 plus R2 into 1 minus cos delta 1. So let this equation be 1. Repeat again, you need not remember the expression in terms of versus sign. This is enough. Okay. V is equals to R1 plus R2 into 1 minus cos delta 1. Next, we'll go with T1E now. T1E is a long chord for the first curve. T1E is the long chord for the first curve. And we have an expression for long chord. T1E is 2R1 into sine delta 1 by 2. Similarly, T2E is the long chord for the second curve. And the expression is 2R2 into sine delta 1 by 2. Remember, delta 2 and delta 1, they are same. So if I could add these two things, I will be getting T1, T2. And remember, T1, T2 is equals to capital L. We have taken it. So L is equals to 2 into R1 plus R2 into sine delta 1 by 2. So let this equation be 2. Keep this equation in the box. So we may have to use it further. Next, if I could consider this triangle, that the triangle is T2A and this one. What I have is, if I go with sine of delta 1 by 2, is it not that that will be equals to sine angle is opposite to hypotenuse, so V by L. Sine of delta 1 by 2 in this triangle is equals to V by L. So I am substituting the equation of L here in this expression. I'm just for getting another expression for L, where L happens to be under the root 2V into R1 plus R2. So this is another expression for L. We have two expressions for L. I can use any of the form here. So L is equal to under the root 2V into R1 plus R2. Let this expression be 3. Next, BE, if I could consider this triangle, B becomes R1 into sine delta 1. Similarly, in this triangle, ED becomes R2 into sine delta 2. Now, if I add these two things, I will be getting BD, whereas BD is equals to H, small h. So, small h is equals to R1 plus R2 into sine delta 1. Okay. So, what we have is, we have expression for V, we have expression for this small h, and we have expression for this capital L, that is T1, T2. Now, what if these two curves have same radius? That is, I'm dealing with R1 equals to R2. That's a special case. Okay. If R1 is equals to R2, so substitute R in all these expressions 1 to 4, then I will be having this set of expression. V is equals to 2R into 1 minus cos delta 1. L is equals to 4R into sine delta 1 by 2. And another expression for L is under the root 4RV or 2 into under the root RV. And H is equals to 2R sine delta 1. So this is another set of expressions what we may have to remember. But this case is holds good when your R1 is equals to R2. Okay, you need not remember this set of equation. If you can remember the above four, if you substitute R1 equals to R2, you will be getting these expressions. We'll go with a numerical one here. Two parallel railway lines are to be connected by a reverse curve, each section having the same radius. If the lines are 12 meter apart and the maximum distance between the tangent points measured parallel to the straight is 48 meter, find the maximum allowable radius. This is part A of the question. Now I have part B. If, however, both the radii are to be different, calculate the radius of the second branch. If that of the first branch is 60 meter, and also calculate the length of both branches. This is part B of the problem. So I'll go with the part A. What we have is they are 12 meter apart. The two tangents are 12 meter apart, and the distance of the radii along the tangent is 48 meter. That is small h. So small h is 48 meter, and V is 12 meter. Okay, but delta 1 is not given. So I have to use this expression, delta 1, tan of delta 1 by 2 is V by H. So in this triangle here, okay, tan of delta 1 by 2 is equals to V by H. V is given, H is given. So I am using this trigonometric function, tan of delta 1 by 2. So tan of delta 1 by 2 is V by H, that is 0.25. So delta 1 happens to be 28 degree 4 minutes. Okay, next in the sketch B, I'm using the same sketch which I have repeated. B is R into sine delta 1 and ED is R into sine delta 1. B plus ED, that is equals to H. Okay, and that is equals to R into sine delta 1 plus R into sine delta 1. So that is 2R sine delta 1. So R happens to be, H is known to us now, H divided by 2 sine delta 1. So R happens to be 51.1 meter. That's what is being asked in the case A. He has asked you to calculate the radius if they are equal. Next, case B is, if the radii are not equal, R1 and R2 are different radii, still your delta 1 happens to be 28 degree 4 minutes. Okay, but what will happen to H is, here your expression for H will be R1 plus R2 into sine delta 1. So let us substitute this. We have H and we have delta 1. So first, what expression we get is R1 plus R2 is 102.2 meter. This is an equation 1. Let us keep this equation as 1. R1 plus R2 as 102.2. Next, he has given you R1. He has given you radius of first curve. If R1 is 60 meter, then what will be R2? It will be 102.2 minus 60. So that will be 42.2 meter. So we have got the radii of both the curves. R1 was given, and R2 we could calculate it. Then he has asked you to calculate length of the branches. So length of the first curve, pi R1 delta 1 by 180. Okay, R1 is 60 meters here. Substitute, you will get this as 29.38. Similarly, length of second branch is pi R2 delta 2 by 180. That is 20.67 meter. Okay, so that is the solution for the first problem. We'll go with the second numerical. A reverse curve connects two parallel tangents 30 meter apart. If the radii of the two branches are 120 meter and 150 meter, determine the following. The distance between the two tangent points, that is capital L. The total length of the curve, so you have to calculate the length of both the curves. Next, if the chainage of point of tangent is 1988 meter, determine the chainage of other points. So here, they are apart by 30 meters. So V is 30, R1 is 120 meter, R2 is 150 meter, they are given. And we know this expression, V is equals to R1 plus R2 into 1 minus cos delta 1. So we'll be getting delta 1 as 27.226 degrees. Next, he has asked you to calculate the distance between the two tangent points, that is capital L, that is T1, T2. So we have this expression, 2 into R1 plus R2 into sine delta 1. So substitute them, you will get length of the distance between the two tangent points as 127.28 meter. Then length of the first curve, L1, so pi r delta 1 by 180, it happens to be 57.11 meter. Length of the second curve, again pi r delta 1 by 180, this is pi r1 delta 1 by 180, and this is pi r2 delta 1 by 180, so that happens to be 71.38 meter. We have chainage of T1 as 1988 meter. Now remember here, we don't call first point as a point of curve. Instead, we call both T1 and T2 as point of tangents. Okay, So tonnage of P1 is given 1988 meter. If we add length of the first curve, we'll get tonnage of point of reverse curvature. The tonnage of PRC is 1988 plus 57.11, that is 2045.11 meter. So that if we add length of the second curve, we get tonnage of the tangent point T2. So tonnage of P2 is 2045.11 plus length of the second curve, that is 71.38, that is 2116.49 meter. So this is the solution. Thank you.